I'm originally from Chicago, Illinois, but I'm Nigerian descent. So, my father's from Nigeria, mother's an African American, yeah, Nigerian descent.
Cool. All right.
Yeah.
Okay. Next question. Kevin Thunderstorm on Instagram. Andrew, how did you get the name The Beast?
As I was growing up, as you know, in the amateurs, I was always calling myself the Beast. And I guess one of the guys that worked for Mayweather Promotions, name is Matt Jung. He just named me that on one of the websites, and I just went with it. Like, okay, yeah, the Beast. All right, so that's yeah,
Okay.
that's a
So Matt gave you that name too, Matt was part of
yeah. I
that?
was
Okay.
actually thinking of a different name than Matt just said, yeah, Beast. And I was like, you know what? I used to call myself that back in the day, so let me go ahead and just take it.
Shout out to Matt Jones.
Yeah.
Okay, Kevin, that was a good question. Kevin from also Mayweather Promotions. Okay, next question. We got Dodge Hood on Instagram. When is Andrew's next fight? Well, I can answer that one. We don't know. We don't know when any of the next fights are, but hopefully, things are coming together, specifically here in the state of Nevada. We're getting good guidance from our governor. We're listening to the health officials, and when they say it's time to go, we're gonna be ready to go.
Yeah,
Okay.
I'm
Next
anxious.
question. Breaking bread on Instagram. Andrew, how was your training overseas with Anthony Joshua? That's a good question.
Training was it was good. It was real good. Just go out there and gain experience from especially a world class fighter, and also it just put me in a place that also could believe in myself and see what I have too, and just going out there and helping the best, one of the best heavyweight champions of the world, get ready, So it was also a confident booster for myself. So it was real great experience to go out there. It was also a good experience, go to
Would
different
you
countries.
say out of the guys that as the guy out of the guys that you were in camp with in with Joshua, do you think that you gave him the best work?
Oh yeah, most definitely. Yeah, I could definitely say I was the number one sparring partner. I think if you see his fight, if you see the highlights of his fight and stuff, and yeah, he had a similar style as me. So it was a lot of I seen a lot of myself in him. So that's so whatever I gave him, he won the fight, and I'm just happy for him.
Good stuff. Good. Okay, next question. DreXXI on Instagram. Andrew, who is the hardest puncher you've ever faced?
As hard as punches I ever faced, I mean, you could go by saying my last fight, that's, I really haven't got hit too much in my career, but you could probably say that on my last fight, Dorticos, and speaking on that, that's definitely love to get a rematch, and revenge that, and so that's one of my future goals to get a rematch on that fight.
Cool. Yeah, I would definitely like to see you get that back. We
Yes.
knew again, like I said, we wish him nothing but the best in his next fight whenever that comes off. And
Right.
again, we have a very good relationship with his team, and we'll see what we can come up with.
Yeah, let's make it
Okay,
happen. Ellie setback.
that's
What's up,
it.
man?
Shout out to Big Ellie in the house. Okay. Next question. Jacob Dieberg 30 on Instagram. Andrew, how quickly can you get into fight ready shape?
Fight ready shape, I say 6 weeks. I stayed always stay in some type of shape. I'm always running, sparring, I'm doing some strength and conditioning. But 6 weeks, I'll be in some fight ready shape, But I'm always in the gym doing something. It's not too much time I'm taking off of getting in the gym. I'm a gym rat. I'm addicted to this boxing game, and I'm always in some shape. I'm never just completely out of shape.
So, Drew, what is let the fans know what your walking around weight is since
Right
you fight.
now, I'm about 220. I'm 220 right now. Before when I start when I started as my pro career, I was walking around about 205. But the time I fight, be like 195, and that was too small for me as a cruiserweight. So, because I run 5 miles a day when I train, so I want to start walking around big, 220. Then just when I get to heavyweight, when I go for the heavyweight, it'd be easy for me to transition to that.
Yeah, because when you eventually do make that move, one thing you will have is a tremendous hand speed advantage, and,
right.
And obviously with your great skill set, you'll be right in the thick of things.
100%.
Next question, Strap2X on Instagram. Andrew, if you had to pick another career outside of boxing, what would it be? That's a good question.
Oh, that's some type of entrepreneur. I want to just be able to, I want to be able to do things like sell like beer products. I'm trying to launch a beer company with my brother. I'm also trying to launch a jump rope company, and also I want to give back just, being a trainer, doing some type of things into the boxing community, give back to, youth and do things like that. Yeah. That's positive.
I said, that's what it's always about, being positive.
Yeah.
Why at Truth on Instagram? Andrew, what video games are you playing right now?
My favorite video game I'm playing is Call of Duty. Yeah, I'm on it all the time.
Call of Duty. You any good?
Yeah. I'm real good at Call of Duty. Anybody want to smoke in Call of Duty? Come on.
Okay, so you put that package out there to the fans.
Yeah. You know, Abby.
Whoever want
Abby,
that work.
Abby and Andrew Tibbetty. Yeah, Call of Duty. Yeah, I'm on it. I'm on it.
Okay, cool. Stacey Mayweather, what's your tag?
That's Stacey. What was that?
That's Stacey.
Well, what did you say?
Oh, you just answered that question. What was your tag?
My tag is Andrew Tibbetty 89. Yeah.
Okay. You got that sack. Sack looking for that work. Okay, next question. L Jody Poeta on Instagram. What are your best exercises for reflex?
I'm just sparring. You got to just sparring for the reflex, and also doing mitts. If you can't get good sparring, doing mitts with your trainer. I'm always shadow boxing, working on different things. Moving your head. But I say main thing is sparring if you want to work on your reflex.
How long are your normal mitt sessions?
My mitt sessions, so it'd be about 30 minutes. I do like 10 minutes, then take probably like a round off, do another 10 minutes, so 20 to 30 minutes of mitts every day. And mitts, cool. It'll help your accuracy, hand-eye coordination, so mitts is really important in this game too.
Cool. Next question. I'm in on Instagram. What are the best tips you've gotten from Floyd Sr.?
Man, a lot of stuff. Just the jab, he had me pumping them jab, three times in a row, I learned a lot of boxing. Most of my boxing, came from Floyd Sr., So when I first came with Floyd, I was just, I was still a pretty good boxer, but I was mostly trying to brawl and, trying to get guys out of there. But he taught me how to be smart in their reflexes and putting the jab and moving, sticking the movement up and down, different punches, punches and bunches, all that stuff. So,
scooping the shot.
Shout out to one of the best.
There's no doubt. I mean, and he taught TBE, so everything,
right.
So, shout out to Big Floyd and holding it down.
Yeah.
Okay. Next question. Mr. Dark Sun, on Instagram. How can I improve my hand speed?
You know, you just got to work on it. You know, I do drills, do just touch drills on the back, 1-2, then, you know, go 30 seconds fast, do a whole bunch of punches fast as you can. Then you go back doing it slow, 30 seconds, then 30 seconds fast, you know, and just, you know, just keep on working on the speed. Like a lot of people work on power, you got to just work on the speed. That's what's one of my main drills for me to get fast on my hands.
Cool. Good stuff. Okay. BigCheese873 on Instagram. Andrew, what inspired you to become a boxer? Good question.
What inspired me? You know, when I was in high school, I was dealing with some things in high school as like with bullies. You know, I was one of the guys getting bullied, and you know, even though I handled them bullies, you know, my stepdad, seeing I was always getting into the fight, so he brought me to the boxing gym, and so every day when I was going to the boxing gym, I was just getting beat up because you know, for me to learn how to fight, I was just getting beat up in the boxing gym, so I was just getting pushed every single day, and I just never quit. And you know, one day I just started getting good at boxing. I just never quit. So I'd say my stepdad was one of the main ones that get me into the boxing. I was about 15, yeah. That's when I first met you, I first met Leonard. I started at Top Rank. It was with Barry Boxing. And I believe Floyd's fighting Zab Judah. My stepdad used to come to you every day and be like, hey, he about to be champ. He about to be world champ. You know, this is the champ right here. And it's just crazy how life works. Now I'm signing with the promotions. It's about 2006, yeah. He's come to you all the time. Floyd's a spar, you know. But, yeah, he's always come. Dad's like, stepdad be like, hey, this champ is about to be the champ. Talk to him all the time. Yeah, and I'm signed to you guys, so, you know.
We believed in you back then because you had a similar build, and for some reason you always reminded me of Evander Holyfield.
Yeah. 100%, yeah.
Good stuff. Okay, next question. Big phrase, boxer. How did you find Sheffield? It was a pleasure to have you over.
Sheffield, UK, man, it was real nice. Everybody's real nice out there. You know, good hospitality. Everybody's real nice. This is one place, I forgot what it's called. I know it's a chicken place. It was real good. We was eating there like every day, you know. But Sheffield was cool. You know, I wanted to go take a look at London. You know, I didn't get the chance to go out there, but man, Sheffield was real cool though.
Cool.
Yeah.
So you didn't get a chance to go to London?
Nah, I didn't get a chance to go. Nah.
Okay. Yeah. How did your interaction with the UK fans? Did you when you were there?